Hey everyone, this is Between Two Lines, the YouTube channel devoted specifically to type 1 diabetes and the struggles keeping your blood sugar between that high line and that low line. My name's Levi, and today I'm talking about two things that I think are important. One's the coronavirus. Obviously, there's a lot of coverage, a lot of information out there. I'm not going to beat a dead horse, but as a type 1 diabetic, there's a couple of things you can control that I don't think are getting talked about enough. And the second thing is going to be something really neat. So if you do have the diabetes, make sure you watch to the end. So obviously one of the most talked about subjects right now is the coronavirus, and I've never really been the kind of guy to worry. And as far as getting sick goes, as a diabetic, you already know, you're pretty much going to get it, whatever it is, so I don't spend time worrying about it. But this is the first time I've kind of felt that bit of concern as far as the coronavirus goes, and it kind of made me realize that if I'm concerned, then I know that means a lot of people are freaking out. Because like I said, I feel like I'm a pretty calm and collected guy, but even when I'm out in public, I kind of have those butterflies in my stomach, kind of nervous feeling, you know, in crowds, and I'm kind of imagining that I'm getting sick, which hopefully next week I'm not making a video about being sick, but I think it's in my head. I'm confident it's in my head, but I still kind of having those feelings, so I know other people are having escalated versions of those emotions. And so it made me think about the things we can control as a diabetic, because you've seen there's a flood of information, man. Wash your hands. Don't be around people that are sick, you know, avoid large crowds, self-quarantine, stuff like that. And with type 1 diabetics, there's been a ton of generic information, like make sure you got all your supplies stocked up. Okay, thanks. And take extra special precaution to avoid crowds. You have a compromised immune system, so treat yourself like it. Got it. But here's a couple of things you can control as a diabetic that I want to reiterate. One of them is manage your diabetes. As important as it is for you to wash your hands and try not to get sick, it's equally as important for you to manage your diabetes, because that's compromising your immune system. If you're letting your blood sugar run high, for example, you're impacting your immune system and its ability to fight off infection. When your blood sugars run high, you're more susceptible, you're more likely to get or catch something. So if you want to control something that's going to improve your odds, or at least make you less susceptible, managing your diabetes has got to be pretty high on the list. So show a little bit of discipline right now in the things that you're eating. You know, maybe reduce the amount of sugar you're taking in or increase your exercise. Check your blood sugar more. If you have a continuous glucose monitor, good on you. If you don't, commit to checking your blood sugar more often to keep tabs on where you're at and put the effort forth to manage diabetes a little bit better right now. The second thing on my list is don't worry so much. And that's easy to say. And I'm not saying there's not legitimacy to what's happening right now. What I'm saying is the worry that's not accomplishing anything, because that's actually a stressor for your body. The more time you spend worrying, it impacts your immune system and your ability to fight off infections. So you're actually making it harder on yourself by worrying about it too much. Take it into consideration what's going on, and I have, and you should too, and you need to make your adjustments, and you need to do the right things, stock up on the right foods, all, you know, all the common sense stuff. Once you've done these things, compartmentalize it and move on. If you spend too much time dwelling on it, you're impacting your immune system in a negative way, because you're adding a whole nother stressor that your body's got to deal with. One more thing you can do if you're really set on fighting the coronavirus is you can send me toilet paper. Because if this stuff doesn't get sorted out in the next couple weeks and the supply chain problems don't get fixed, we're going to have a problem in my house. So I'm taking all donations, anything you've got on the toilet paper front. I mean, obviously I'm kidding, but man, never thought I'd be worried about how much toilet paper we had left in the house. That moves on to the second thing I want to talk about today. Something neat. If you haven't been around watching this channel for the past couple months, then you may not be aware that it's only been around a couple of months. And all this has happened so quickly and so fast. I've gotten to interview some neat people, been contacted by a lot of foundations and groups. Did a cool interview with Diabetes Daily, which is a publication that if you haven't subscribed to it, check it out. I'll put the link to the article in the description below. So if you're interested in reading that, getting a little backstory on some of the videos I've made. That was a really cool experience. And then I was on a podcast with Diabetes Daily Grind, which the first time I listened to it, I was mortified, because if you watch any of these films, you know, I'm not terribly open about it. These videos are kind of a new thing. When I watched it, I was like, oh man, I got more personal than I probably would have if I had gotten to plan my responses, but it's a good thing. So I will put that in the description as well. That one you can, if you're interested in a little deeper dive into who I am and how I got to where I am today, that's worth a listen. So through these interviews and conversations and messages and comments and emails talking to all you guys, it was pointed out to me this caused a ripple that is something new in the diabetic community. And that was that pretty much all the diabetics that are active online fall into one of a few categories. You're the top 20%. You guys are the guys killing it. And you post all the time. You're the phenoms. You're the superstars. You've got your blood sugars perfect. You're fit. You're active. You post things that are encouraging to the rest of us that want to be more like that. And then there's the bottom 20%. And y'all post a lot too because you guys are falling apart, right? You're having a terrible time and you're reaching out for help. Hey, I'm really struggling with this. What do you guys think? Or hey, I need motivation. Or hey, I'm dealing with these complications from years of neglect. I need motivation to get things turned around. You guys post a lot too because you're crying out for help, and good on you. The middle 60% is where a lot of people are that are people a lot like me. I looked at the stuff, I read it, but never commented, never engaged. I was just a middle of the road diabetic. I wasn't the worst, wasn't the best, just tackling it day by day. That 60% is who's been engaging the most with these videos. And it really got me thinking that, A, obviously I need to keep making them because there's other people out there that are like me. And that was really encouraging. But B, I realized the 60% are now infecting each other. I've just become a mediator to this. I'll talk about stuff and make videos, and all of a sudden there'll be conversations and comments, and it starts the ball rolling for people who maybe didn't typically interact with these types of things. So we need to take that and run with it, because now we've started something. And here's what I want you to do. If you're watching this video, I want you to comment on the video. And if you're like me, you're watching this and probably thinking, I've never commented on a YouTube video before. I sure ain't comment on one for you, dude. But I want you to do it. I want you to comment on the video something that you're going to do better as a diabetic. Not something you want to do, not something you're going to try to do or wish you could do, but something you will do better. Make it something small. I'm going to exercise more. I'm going to check my blood sugar more. I'm going to eat better. Put something in the comments, because here's what's going to happen. Obviously, you're going to feel some accountability because you wrote it, you saw it, you know it's out there, you know I've seen it. But more important than that is the impact it's having on the rest of us. Because every time a new comment pops up, there's another guy or another girl out there that's similar to you that's like, you know what, I'm going to put something on there. And it's contributing to the cause and causing this snowball effect. So put something on there that you're going to do better, because the more that we contribute to one another, the better off we all are. So I'll start with myself. I'm going to do better at not overreacting to low blood sugars, because I kind of spaz out and eat everything. I'll stop at a convenience store or clear out my kitchen. You know, I'll be 65 and dropping, which is a big deal. I'll eat so much sugar and junk food that an hour later I'm at 330. And you know how that goes. It's a roller coaster for the rest of the day trying to get things leveled back out. So I need to quit being such a spaz when my blood sugar goes low. And that is what I'm going to do better at. If you haven't subscribed, make sure you hit the bell so you know when new videos come out. My name's Levi. This is Between Two Lines.